Hello Leo, how are you doing today? This reading is all about what you need to be aware of, what can catch you off guard in the next couple of weeks to come. So, you know, sometimes we need to have a bit of a checkup on the energies, and we do have to have a look at what can be something that we don't want to see that can happen. So let's clear the space of any previous energies or readings that I've done on this table, and then send good vibes out to you guys out there. The first couple of cards I'm going to get out is going to be the overall kind of energy that we're looking at what can come in here that can catch you off guard. So let's get the card shuffled and let's begin. If you guys do want to have a personal reading with me, link in the description box below, and they are marked down and discounted until the end of June. Yes, so let's get started. I got a card coming up here. It is the Hierophant energy in the reverse position, Two of Inspiration. Spirit guide, did you learn? I just said, did you learn your lesson? And I'm like, okay, there's X's coming out the woodwork. Yeah, I'm telling you. For some of you guys, this is definitely a person here that wants to come back in here. There is a person. Got a page of voices here. There's a person that wants to come back in. They're not coming back in very smoothly. You have had a connection to them in the past. It's a Two of Wands energy that comes up here that makes me go. And with the Hierophant there, that's why I said, did Spirit just said, did you learn your lesson with regards to this person's energy? What I can tell you here with the inspiration energy, yes, you were in a connection with this person. You could have been friends for a little while before you got maybe more involved with each other. But for others of you, this is like a friend situationship. Relationships, friendship, situation. What is this? What is this kind of vibe? It's I don't know what it is. You may not know what it is either. This could be like something like friends with benefits kind of vibe coming up here. I've never actually picked it up before. Yes, you with this person, you push them away and they come back in as you like, let me just be friends with them. But every time it's like, let me just be friends with them, it kind of goes to more than just being friends with them. They're very impulsive here. So when they come in, this is a very high energy person with a very high energy. Can even be an air sign, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius as well. The thing is with them, they're not offering. They come in with the Four of Cups. I mean, that's the Four of Cups energy. They come in and offer you that cup of love, even though sometimes, let's just be friends, you know, let's not hate each other, let's be friends with each other, you know, that kind of vibe. The thing is with this energy is that sometimes it's not really what you want. It's not really what you want. I feel like even though you may even talk about it quite openly, you may say to each other, yeah, no, we're just going to be friends with each other. We're cool. But truly in the deeper energy of your heart, it's not really what you want. You really want to have something much more deeper. There is a lesson that you are learning here throughout this entire situation, bringing up this Hierophant energy here, being Taurus as well. The Taurus's card. The Hierophant energy indicates a wisdom. It's almost like through this experience, like you're experiencing it the first time, maybe the second time, maybe the third time, you know what I mean? Because you know when we sort of make friends with a person, but there's a bit more than friendship going on here, it can get extremely complicated. There's no set rules in the beginning of the connection. It's just sort of a whatever happens, whatever goes, goes. So there's no accountability here. So you can't say to somebody, but I thought we were dating. Why are you doing that? They're going to come up and go, but you know, we always just had a casual connection. There's your problem. You see, casual connections, guys, the heart will get involved. Dreams will come in and hope for love will come in. No matter what, we're human beings. No matter as much as we try to separate our heart, mind and body, it is not going to happen. You're anchored in that body, your soul is in there, and your heart is beating, and your brain is working. It's not going to stop. There's going to be a connection anyway. So we need to be very careful just doing casual sort of things. So I want to go a little bit deeper in here. The Fool card, there's the same kind of energy. The Page of Voices energy with the Fool card, it's almost this energy of impulsivity, of doing things without really thinking on a deeper level. But you may have done this a few times with this person. It's nothing wrong with that. But I think you're gaining some wisdom here from doing it. It's almost like you're going, you know what? I think this is not good for me. I think this is not good for me, especially because the Four of Cups is there. It's like in the beginning, you're going, yeah, why not? Why not? But as time goes on, you're starting to realize this may not be the best thing for me, you know? Let's have a look, because your heart is getting affected. your heart is getting affected here, and you're affecting your emotional body as well. And because they also know that they can come back into you like a friend, and then later on things will go a bit further somewhere down the line. After one night when you're laughing with each other late in the middle of the night, it's just going to be that energy of something very casual happening, but your heart is getting affected. Even if you don't love, yes, there's your Five of Cups, your heart is absolutely getting affected. Even if you don't love this person, even if you don't love this person, I can't say you're madly in love with them, but you know what, when we share our energy with another person, even, I'm going to put this one out there, even if it's a long distance relationship and we're chatting with somebody in whatever way you're chatting with them, you're still sharing energy. It doesn't matter the distance between, you don't have to physically touch a person. Now, when you share your energy with a person, they sharing their energy with you, it's going to rub off on you on an emotional level. And whatever happens after that will affect you on an emotional level. And you also affecting your own emotional body as well. It can cause you a disruption in your energy with regards to other things in your world as well. So sometimes you might find like sharing your energy with some people or a person that's not really committed to you, or not really that you love them and they really love you, can cause a disruption in workplace or in financial areas as well, because of just literally the energy not being smooth, like the water in your body, the energy of your flow, it's not being smooth. And this is your Five of Cups energy. Without a doubt, it's affecting the Five of Cups. It's about emotions. It is affecting your emotions. It is getting to you eventually. So letting this person back in and letting them go and letting back in and letting them go, it's not the best of things. And this is them going again. Okay, that's what you don't like. It never goes anywhere. Whatever has happened in the past, you know, sometimes we're with somebody as a friendship and then something happens, it becomes a situationship, you know what I mean? And then the next thing you're looking and then you're going, you know, maybe we will be with each other. Maybe something will grow from this. No, it's always not what you want, because they always end up walking away. And when they walk away, there's your Five of Cups. Your heart gets hurt. Your emotions get hurt. Even if it's not full-blown love, but somewhere along the line, emotions are getting hurt here. Let's go. Let's see what your spirit guides have got to say. Modern times, guys. No, this has been going on since the beginning of time. There you go. Ace of Wands. Communication over the phone. Somebody talking to you. Ace of Pentacles. Wow. Pretty straightforward here. They're literally going, yeah. It is going to be them coming back in very impulsively with the Page of Voices, with the Page of Wands being there. Communication over the phone can even be a younger person because of the Wands being in the reverse position. This is never what it's going to be. It's never going here. The Ace of Pentacles is in the reverse position. It's never going to be marriage, guys. It's never going to be an energy of you settling down with them and growing to get to the Ten of Pentacles. It's always going to be a very casual situation. Can you emotionally handle that? Let's go in just a little bit deeper for you guys and get just some final looks at what we have going on here. So be very careful. Wow. I'm just checking if it's one card. No, be careful. This is going to be too much for you eventually to carry. Chariot card in the reverse position. High Priestess, you need to learn your lessons here. It's going to eventually end up hurting you in a much deeper level. This person's never really interested in starting a serious relationship. It's always going to be a casual thing. It's always going to be the situationship. It will always go the way that you don't want it to go with the Chariot card. Also Cancer's energy as well. It's always going to be this energy of it going where you don't want it to go. It's never going to be on the road to stability. It's never going to go to the place where you want it to be. And that in the long run is going to hurt you. The Ten of Swords here, that's a painful experience that you're going to have to go through. And if you choose to go through it again and again, it's almost like it doesn't hurt you so deeply. Okay, listen to this. It's not like you have a total heartbreak and it's a ending of the world kind of vibe and, you know, you don't get out of bed for 2 weeks kind of vibe. No, it's like little pains. It's like a little hurt. So it's one little sword and happens next time and it's a little pain and it's one little sword. But all those little pains, all those little sadnesses, those little emotional hurts adds up to something really big in the long run, you see. And then there's your High Priestess. It's like they're going, trust your intuition here. Do listen to your soul that's trying to speak to you. Listen to the heart that's trying to send you the information about this person and what they are going to do. Because what they have done in the past, they're going to do it again in the future. No matter what comes out of their mouth, they will repeat an ongoing pattern here with you. And I do see them walking away with this Page of Pentacles. Do you allow yourself to get put in harm's way again? Did you learn your lessons? So there we go, guys. Thank you so much for listening to the reading. I'm sending my love and light in your direction. Bye.